Welcome back to the class. Today, children, let us try to understand the chapter Construction of Quadrilaterals. We all know that a quadrilateral is a closed four-sided figure. So, you can see here that there are four sides, side 1, side 2, side 3 and side 4. So, these are the four sides of a quadrilateral and it is a closed figure. Now, quadrilaterals can be of different types. In the sense, based on its property, we can decide what is the name of the quadrilateral. For example, you can see that if all the four sides are of different lengths, that is, if they don't have the same length, they are of different length, it is just called as a quadrilateral. But if you see that one of the opposite pair is parallel to each other, in this figure, you can observe that in this quadrilateral, you are observing that one of the opposite pair, that is, if I name it as A, B, C and D, now here side AB and side CD are opposite to each other and they are parallel, that is, I can write as AB parallel to CD. So, in such case, the quadrilateral is named as trapezium. So, now we can see one more quadrilateral here where the same trapezium keeping the same opposite sides parallel. Now if I try to change the remaining two sides, that is the other pair also parallel, you can observe this is a symbol that is used to show the parallel lines. Okay, now these two, that is if I name it as again A, B, C, D, already we have AB parallel to CD and also the other side BC is parallel to AD. So, here both opposite pairs are parallel to each other. So, in such case we call it as parallelogram. So, the quadrilateral is called as parallelogram. Now, in this parallelogram we have so many properties. For example, all the four angles when we consider, opposite angles of a parallelogram will be equal, that is angle B will be equal to angle D and angle C will be equal to angle A. And also opposite sides, not only they will be parallel but they will be even equal, that is AB will be equal to CD and BC will be equal to AD. So opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel and equal, we can say that they are also equal. Now coming to the opposite angles, they are also equal. So I can write angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. Also adjacent angles are supplementary, that means if I add any two adjacent angles in this parallelogram, it will become 180 degrees. That means if I add A plus B, it will be 180 degrees, B plus C 180, C plus D 180, same way D plus A also will give me 180. So adjacent angles are supplementary, we say that adjacent angles are supplementary. Now here, if you take the same parallelogram and do little changes, what are the changes?